In this problem, the impulse response of the system is given, that is h of n is equal to 2, 1 and minus 1. Similarly, the input sequence x of n is given, that is 1, 2, 3, 3, 2 and 1. So we supposed to find the output of the system y of n. Here output of the system y of n is nothing but the linear convolution between h of n and x of n. Here the length of h of n is, let L be the length of h of n, it is 3. The length of x of n, let it be m, it is 6. So in linear convolution, the length of the output sequence must be sum of these two minus 1, that is 6 plus 3, 9 minus 1, that is the length of output sequence, that is we can say length of output sequence is equal to L plus M minus 1, that is nothing but 3 plus 6 minus 1, it should be 8. So we have to perform y of n using circular convolution. We know that in circular convolution the length of both the sequences must be same. So in h of n the length is 3, we suppose to add 5 more zeros to make the length equal to 8. Similarly in x of n we have 6 samples, we suppose to add 2 more samples to make it length 8. So now I can represent the new h of n as 2, 1, minus 1. I'll add remaining 5 zeros to make the length of this as 8. Similarly, the length of x of n supposed to be make it 8 by adding or padding zeros. That is 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, we supposed to add 2 more zeros. So now the length of h of n is 8. Similarly, length of x of n is also 8. We can also use the formula, that is we supposed to add m minus 1 zeros to h of n and l minus 1 zeros to x of n to make the length equal. Now we have to perform the circular convolution between h of n and x of n. That is, we supposed to find circular convolution between x of n and h of n. So here we can use any method to calculate the circular convolution. Let us perform the circular convolution using matrix method. That is y of n is equal to, in matrix method the one sequence supposed to be written in matrix form. I'll write x of n in matrix form, 3, 2. So now horizontally the same sequence should be written in reverse order, that is 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2. Now shift the first row by one position, 1, 0, 0, this 1 supposed to be right here, 2, 3, 3, this 2 supposed to be written here, 1, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2 and 1. Now here we suppose to write the H of n matrix, that is 2, 1, minus 1, rest all are zeros. So let's perform the multiplication between these two matrices. 1 into 2, that is 2. 0 into 1, this is 0. 0 into 1, this is 0. Then rest all values are 0. So the first value is 2. Next, second row is multiplied with the column, that is 2 into 2, 4. 1 into 1, that is 1. Next 2 values are 0. Next 4 values are 0. Next multiply third row with column, 3 into 2 is 6, plus 2 is multiplied with 1, that is 2, 1 is multiplied with minus 1, that is minus 1. Similarly, the fourth row is multiplied with the column, 3 into 2 is 6, plus 3 into 1 is 3, plus 2 into minus 1 is minus 2, rest all values are 0. Next 2 into 2 is 4, 3 into 1 is 3, 3 into minus 1 is minus 3, so rest all values are 0. Now multiplying 1 with 2, it gives 2, plus 2 into 1 is 2, 3 into minus 1 is minus 3, 0 into 2 is 0, 1 into 1 is 1, 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. Next last row, that is 0 into 2 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, rest all values are 0. Therefore, the final y of n is 2, 5, 7, 9 minus 2, 7, 7 minus 3 is 4, 4 minus 3 is 1, this is minus 1 and this is minus 1. So, this is the result of circular convolution of x of n and h of n. Now let us verify whether this answer is correct or not. Just now we performed a circular convolution between x of n and h of n. We got the result as 2, 5, 7, 7, 4, 1, minus 1 and minus 1. So it has 8 samples. Now let us verify the result. So here y of n is nothing but the linear convolution between x of n and h of n. Now we will perform the linear convolution by direct method. We know that the given x of n is 1, 2, 3, 3, 2 and 1, and given h of n is 2, 1 and minus 1. Now let's see how to perform linear convolution directly. So here consider the original length, that is x of n is 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1 and h of n is 2, 1, minus 1. Write the sequence x of n here, that is 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1. This is x of n length sequence and h of n here 2, 1, minus 1. So this is h of n sequence, this is x of n sequence. Now perform multiplication between this value with all the values of x of n, that is 2 into 1 is 2, 4, 6, 6, 4, 2. Similarly, multiply 1 with all the values 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1. So this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1. Now, write the output sequence y of n such that here take the first element, that is 2. In next side, next consider these two diagonal values and add them, that is 4 plus 1 is 5. Next consider the diagonal values 6, 2 and minus 1, add them. 6 plus 2 is 8, 8 minus 1 is 7. Similarly, the next diagonal values are 6, 3 and minus 2. 6 plus 3 is 9, 9 minus 2 is 7. Next diagonal values are 4, 3 and minus 3. That is 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 minus 3 is 4. Next values are 3, 2, 2. That is 2 plus 2 is 4, 4 minus 3 is 1. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1 and minus 1. So this is the linear convolution result after direct method. So now this value is equal to this value. So it is verified. Thank you.